In 1987, the area you are presently in was full of old mine waste dumps and had been approved by the local council to be landscaped and turned into a car park.
Back in 1987, we started work here to survey for a car park scheme. It's an amazing thought that this was just a desolate piece of wasteland.
But first, an underground survey would be required. Mining consultants were awarded the contract to access the mine and conduct the survey.
We located and opened one of the old mining shafts, Absale Dam, and discovered dozens of passages, tunnels and caverns, far more than we had ever anticipated.
Inside, the team discovered thousands of ancient tools.
It's very clear that the tunnels we discovered didn't just date back to the 18th and 19th centuries. They were obviously very old. The tools that we found scattered around, stone hammers and pieces of animal bone, and the indications were that these tunnels were thousands of years old.
The team sent off charcoal and bone found in the mine to be used in a process called radiocarbon dating. It would let them know exactly how old the mine was. Scholars believe that metal mining in the UK was not started until after the Romans came to Britain in 43 AD. But the results of the carbon dating would surprise everyone and change the early history of Great Britain. The mines were dated at a staggering 1800 BC, 2000 years before the Romans arrived. Suddenly it was realized that the people of the Bronze Age were far more accomplished than history had given them credit for.
We know from this period that there were some great structures built, like Stonehenge, and we put them on the front page of mystery books. But they're not mysteries. There were some first-class engineers.
Using stone hammers and bone scrapers, the ancient miners had mined for the green ore malachite that could be smelted to produce copper. The age of metal had begun. In 1990, planning permission was granted to open the site to the public and continue the excavation and exploration.
Recent research has suggested that up to 1,700 tons of copper metal was produced from this mine in the Bronze Age, and that would be enough to make up to 10 million bronze axes.
No doubt. Such vast resources would have brought the people in control of the mine great wealth and status. It also makes it the largest industrial site of the ancient world. And this is just based on the parts of the mine that have been excavated. Potentially, the site could be much larger. In fact, bear in mind as you walk the 200 meters of underground passages today that they represent only 3% of the Bronze Age working survey. There are at least 5 miles of Bronze Age passages under your feet. Today, the site looks very different, and the original team who discovered it continue to excavate and run the attraction. New discoveries continue to be made every year. In 1987, they found this. After 5 years of extensive excavation, they unearthed one of the largest man-made prehistoric chambers anywhere in the world, and the whole thing would have been originally carved out with nothing more than simple stones and bones.
When we first crawled into the cap, you could touch the roof with your hand. It had been backfilled with hundreds of tons of waste rock. It took us 5 years to excavate by hand to reveal what you can see today.
The Bronze Age copper mines at the Great Holm are the most extensive discovered anywhere in the world. A true history-changing find that has lain hidden for over 4,000 years. A discovery that now you are about to see for yourself.